The second interesting app today is Write on PDF. You know, very often we get lots of material on PDF these days, and we want to annotate on that PDF. We want to give our approval, we want to give a signature, we want to write something, we want to insert something. So there is a very simple app which is made by Samsung, which is called Write on PDF. So you just say Write on PDF. Can you see the app name? Write on PDF. Okay. So I'll just open the app and it shows me all the PDFs that are there in my phone. So all the PDFs that are there on my phone are now here. Now I'll just pick up something, say 16 September, I have an invite. So I pick up that PDF. Now this is the PDF that is there. Now you can use your notebook pen, or you can use your finger. You see the pen on top. If I click on the pen, all the options for the pens are there. One is a proper pen, a graded pen. There is a pencil, there is a sharp pencil, there is a highlighter, and there is a marker which is a little blurred. So no, it doesn't work only on Samsung. You can it works on all phones. So I'll pick up the pencil. I'll pick up the size or thickness of the, so I'll pick up this thickness, and I'll pick up the color of the annotation. Suppose I want to use red color only. Okay, and I say close. Now after doing this, I can, if you see my pen hovering on this, I can mark something on this PDF straight away. I can sign on this PDF straight away. Suppose I want to sign. Let me see if I can use a black so it will be more visible. Make it a little thicker. And I say close. So if I want to sign here, I can sign here. If I want to put an arrow, I can put an arrow. If I want to put an arrow here, anywhere on the PDF. No, it will not scratch the screen. Don't use a sharp pencil. I am using a Samsung Note, so there is a inbuilt pen available. You use a blunt object. Use any blunt object and it is okay. Or you can even use your finger. Now I am not using the pen. Now I am using my finger. So now see how it works. This is my finger working. How to open? On top you have pen. See, on the top you will see pen, eraser, text, and undo. So let me see, let me discard everything and start again. I'll discard everything, and again I start with this particular image. Okay, now I'm using my finger, I'm not using my pen. Okay, I'm using my finger. I'm saying pen settings, I am using a pencil, I am taking a black color or maybe a purple color this time, and make it little more thick, and I close it. Now see, I'm using my finger. Can you see that? I can draw an arrow, I can draw a circle, I can draw a square, whatever I feel like. How to open the pencil pen icon? You just tap on it. You just tap on the top left, the pen icon. Just tap on it and it will be opened. Yes, it can be downloaded from the Play Store. This is very, very useful for, and you can even put text. So if I want to put text, I come here, I click on text. Now see, I can type any text. I am taking some large font so that it is visible, and I start typing here. This is cool. Can you see what I am typing? Yes, it is available on, it may not be available exactly on iPhone. There could be a different app for the iPhone, but you just search for Write on PDF. That is the easiest way of searching on iPhone. Can you see what I am doing? I am just typing here whatever I feel like typing, and I can then save it and share it or whatever. Then I have an eraser tool. So if I use the eraser, erase touched area or erase line by line. So I'll say erase touched area. So I will go and erase this. I'm just moving my finger on this, and I can erase it just like as if I'm using an eraser. I'm using my finger. I'm not using anything else. Okay. Now, when I'm coming on this, I can undo stuff. I can redo stuff. So it is very, very simple to handle. You can just say save, or you can say add to shortcuts. Now, S Pen is only for the Samsung mobile, Samsung Note. So you don't have to worry about that. You can use your finger also. Don't use a sharp edge, so you don't scratch the screen. Use a simple, a blunt object, or even the backside of your ball pen. If it is thin enough, you can just start drawing. You can make it as thick as you want. You can use a highlighter. Suppose I want to use a highlighter. I use a highlighter and I make it say orange. Okay. And I say I want to highlight this. I want to highlight this. I just move my finger on this. I am highlighting stuff. Yeah, there are many apps which are having the same features. Not to worry, I am showing you one app. There are millions of apps which will have similar features, which will have more features, less features. This is one of the apps that we are talking about. Okay, so this is very simple to use. You just click on it and use the pen or the eraser or the text tool, and you can straight away start annotating a PDF. So it could be any PDF. Like you can say, I can pick up anything on my mobile. I want to highlight something here. I say highlight this. Okay, so straight away you can highlight stuff. You can use the pen tool. You can use the pencil tool. You can do whatever you want. And the beauty of this whole thing is that if you don't like all the colors that they give, you can even tap on this and then select the color and create a color of your choice. You can say, I want this color. Okay. And say done. So now everything will be green. No, you don't use it. This is an app. So apps are always used on the phone. They are not used on the laptop. Okay. But now Microsoft Windows has started allowing you the new version when it comes, the new update when it comes, it will allow you to actually use all Android apps on your laptop. So that will be a great thing. Then you can use all the things that we are talking of directly on the laptop. If you have a touch screen, although more better, then you can use all these gestures and everything directly on your laptop also. So this is the second app that we are talking of. Very, very useful when you are dealing with